The angel Gabriel came unto Mary and said, Hail thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father,
we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep.
May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant us absolution and remission of all our sins, true repentance, amendment of life, and the grace and consolation of his Holy Spirit.
Praise ye the Lord.
Lord,
A lesson from the first book of Samuel. Anna also prayed and said, "My heart exalts in the Lord. My strength is exalted in the Lord. My mouth derides my enemies, because I rejoice in your salvation. There is none holy like the Lord. There is none beside you. There is no rock like our God. Talk no more so very proudly. Let not arrogance come from your mouth. For the Lord is a God of knowledge, and by him actions are weighed. The bows of the mighty are broken, but the feeble gird strength. Those who were full have hired themselves out for bread, but those who were hungry have ceased to be hungry. The barren has borne seven, but she who has many children is forlorn. The Lord kills and brings to life. He brings down to Sheol and he raises up. The Lord makes poor and makes rich. He brings low, he also exalts. He raises up the poor from the dust, but he lifts the needy from the dung heap, to make them all sit with princes and inherit a seat of honor. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and on them he has set up the world. He will guard the feet of his faithful ones, but the wicked shall be cut off in darkness. For not by might shall man prevail. The adversaries of the Lord shall be broken to pieces. Against them will he thunder in heaven. The Lord will judge the ends of the earth. He will give strength to his king and exalt the power of his anointed." Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you. lesson from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to send her away quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you.
Lord be with you. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
O Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the state.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
And you, thy ministers, with righteousness. Mystery of the Word made flesh, didst in thy mercy sanctify the house of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Do thou grant that we may keep aloof from the tabernacle of sinners and become worthy indwellers of thy house. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we, being defended from the fear of all enemies,
may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. Light in our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies,
we, thy unworthy servants, forgive thee most humble of our times, for all thy goodness and loving kindness, all us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, of all the blessings of this life, of all the kindness and the love, and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory, humbly beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeigned and thankful, and that we show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom we thee and the Holy Ghost, be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and dost promise that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting.
Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore.
Dear faithful, in the year of our Lord 1061, it was some 3 years after the last raid of Vikings coming in to the country of England. It was 5 years before another group of Vikings settled on the northern coast of France, known as the Normans, would come and take away Anglo-Saxon culture forever. In the year of our Lord 1061, in a moment of peace between those two things, Mary, the Mother of God, appeared to the Lady Richeldis in a little hamlet called Walsingham, England. It was there that she disclosed to Richeldis the dimensions of the holy house where she had received the Annunciation from Gabriel. And it was there that she asked Richeldis to build a house. And it's important the reason why. So that the faithful who came to that house would receive the joy that she had received at the Annunciation. The joy of saying yes to God's ways for our lives, the ultimate joy of following his ways every step and every day we have. Thus, 958 years ago, Mary appeared in Walsingham. And today, on this evening, this solemnity of title for this cathedral parish, we sit in a holy house, glorifying and magnifying Almighty God with our voices. Truly, we are here striving to follow his ways, and we are here receiving that joy that Mary received at the Annunciation. Thank you for your presence here tonight at the Cathedral of Our Lady of Walsingham. Do know that this is the 20th year of Chorus Angelorum, our in-residence choral group as they have lifted their voices in the beauty of holiness and led us in sacred music in the English tradition for 2 decades. For those members that are here tonight, thank you for that. We hope to be led in sacred music for another 20 by you or more. For those who have supported this great mission of promoting sacred music for the evangelization of souls, that's exactly what it is. Thank you. Dear faithful, we ask that you join us on this, our feast of title, this evening in St. Jude Hall for a reception, as we continue to thank Almighty God for Mary's witness to Rocheltus, to say fiat, to say yes to God's ways, and receive ultimate joy from him alone. Thank you again for your presence at the cathedral.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.
And we deliver us of Christ.
Let us pray, Almighty and Everlasting God, who by the cooperation of the Holy Ghost didst prepare the body and soul of the glorious Virgin Mother Mary to become a habitation meet for thy Son. Grant that as we rejoice in her commemoration, we may be delivered by her loving intercession from our present evils and from eternal death, through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.